G'day everyone, let's talk about input remapping in Godot. In my game, I have this settings menu that lets you remap the buttons used for input. It supports keyboard if applicable, and if there's a controller connected, then it shows up options for that too. In this video, I'll show you how this works as well as a few other handy input related things. My game detects the currently active input device and swaps out the input prompts to match whatever the device is. This is a graphical wrapper around the Input Helper add-on for Godot. Input Helper is available from the asset library or on GitHub. So, this input prompt node is basically just a sprite that updates its texture depending on the action it represents and the currently active input device. This one is set to UI Inventory and Device Auto, so it uses Input Helper to look up the current input for UI Inventory against whatever device is currently active. So if the player is using the keyboard, we end up with the B key being shown. But if I switch to my Xbox controller, then we end up with the Y button being shown. I've drawn a bunch of my own input prompt graphics, but if you wanted something like this, but didn't want to draw your own, you can always get a pack from Itch or one from the one and only Kenny. Okay, let's have a look how the player can remap these buttons. Firstly, I have this settings menu. If you want to know more about how to build a menu like this, then I have another video about it on my channel. Okay, this menu doesn't have a whole lot in it just yet, but for now, we only really care about the input settings. As part of these menu items, I have a node that, when selected, handles getting a new input for a given action. So when it's selected, it throws up this overlay that has a GUI input signal attached to it. When that signal fires, it is given an input event. I check that event to make sure it's one that I can use for input. If it is, then I use the input helper to update the input map for this action, and if there are any clashes, it automatically swaps them out for the one we just replaced. It's that simple. Now, if you want to persist these controls, you'll have to save them to file. While the input helper doesn't actually do the saving and loading part, it does provide methods for serializing and deserializing the data for input mappings. You can use those methods alongside however else you're saving the settings for your game. I use GDScript for all of the code in my game, but the input helper does have full C# support. If you add a using Nathan Hode statement to the file, then you can call methods on the input helper like you would in GDScript. The input helper add-on does a bunch of other handy stuff, and I encourage you to check it out on GitHub. Let me know in the comments if there's something input related that you want to know more about. And if you want to help support the development of add-ons like Input Helper, then become a patron today. Patrons get access to all of the code snippets that I've been sharing too. And speaking of my Patreon, I'd like to thank this month's Cockatoo supporter, Vanillid. And a big thanks to this month's Owl supporter, Linus Minus. And that's all from me for now. Until next time, bye.